بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، أما بعد. In today's episode, the first episode, we shall discuss about the noble features of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. Hadith is in Bukhari and Muslim and is Sahih. Anas رضي الله عنه reports: كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ليس بالطويل البائن ولا بالقصير. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم was neither tall nor very short like a dwarf. ولا بالأبيض الأمهق ولا بالآدم. In complexion, he was neither very white like lime or we call chalk white. ولا بالآدم. Nor was he dark. ولا بالجعد القطط ولا بالسبت. He did not have curly hair nor very straight hair. بعثه الله تعالى على رأس 40 سنة. When he attained the age of 40, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted him nubuwa, i.e. prophethood. فأقام بمكة 10 سنين وبالمدينة 10 سنين. He lived in Mecca for 10 years and in Medina for 10 years. وتوفاه الله على رأس 60 سنين. He passed away at the age of 60. وليس في رأسه ولحيته 20 شعرة بيضاء. At that time, there were not more than 20 white hair on his Mubarak head and beard. Subhanallah. Another hadith, which is also in Bukhari and Muslim, and is Sahih. Bara bin Azib radiyallahu anhu relates that كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم رجلا مربوعا. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم was a man of medium build. بعيد ما بين المنكبين. He had broad shoulders. عظيم الجمة إلى شحمة أذنيه. He had dense hair which reached his earlobes. عليه حلة حمراء. He wore a red striped lungi and shawl. ما رأيت قط أحسن منه. I never saw anybody or anything more handsome than him. Also another hadith in Muslim and Tirmidhi, which is again Sahih. Jabir bin Samura radiyallahu anhu says, كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أشكل العين منهوس العقب. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم had a wide mouth. There were red lines in the whiteness of his eyes. He had little flesh on his heels. It is desirable for Arab men to have wide mouths. According to some, a wide mouth means eloquence, fluency of language. The translation adopted in the description of the eyes has been taken from accepted sayings. However, in this hadith, Imam Tirmidhi has translated this to mean wide eyes. Ashkal al-Ain, he translates this to be wide eyes, which according to the linguists is not correct. And finally, another narration in Tirmidhi is narrated once again by Jabir bin Samura radiyallahu anhu that he said, رأيت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في ليلة إضحيان وعليه حلة حمراء فجعلت أنظر إليه وإلى القمر فله عندي أحسن من القمر. I once saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the night of a full moon. On that night, he wore a red clothing. At times, I looked at the full moon, and at times, I looked at Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ultimately, I came to the conclusion that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was more handsome, beautiful, and radiant than the full moon. Subhanallah. This was how perfect our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was. Today, many people are trying to look perfect, spending millions of dollars on cosmetic surgeries and whatnot. But still, they are not even close to being perfect. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with so much perfection that there was no one before him or after him who was more beautiful and perfect than him. This was our master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Let's connect once again through another episode. Until then, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.